大家好，我是光哥，今天很高兴我们可以采访到斐利牧师，然后呢他在印尼，所以呢我们希望可以更多的了解现在在印尼所发生的事情，还有他们的教会所发生的事情。 Hello Philip，很高兴菲利牧师能够看到你在线上。Hello. 台湾的弟兄姐妹都非常的想念你。
我也想念你们，超想念台湾的。
OK，好，本来你三月好像四月都要来台湾的，但是现在都没有办法来了，是因为这个
这个
疫情的这个事情发生。然后呢，我想要问一下菲利牧师，就是听说你们的教会在三个礼拜之前的时候就没有办法再聚会，所以变成转到 online， 就是转到线上聚会。那我想要问一下说这些事情的发生可能对你们的 family， 对你们的家庭，还有对你们的教会有些什么样子的影响？
So this condition has affected our family in a good way actually. Because right now I'm staying home most of the time. Having canceled all my speaking schedules and traveling schedules and traveling plans, therefore I'm stayed put at home. So I could have 3 meals a day together with my family. So that's a very rare thing in my life nowadays. But now that I could always spend day and night with my loved ones, and I couldn't be more thankful. It's a blessing in disguise.
那我想要问一下说自从这个coronavirus发生了以后，然后有没有影响你们在教会的里面，譬如说当然聚会要 online， 然后或者是你们怎么样 do cell group， 或是你们的整个的教会的 community 怎么样 stay together 在这样子的一个疫情的当中。
In order to support our government and also our society, we have chosen to go online. That has become a blessing to our church. How is that so? Because since going online, you know, there are more people that have reached outNow also our cell group, 我们的小组 we went online also. This phrase has become very famous in our church. There is no distance in the presence of God. So we are all believing that is so. And I could hold twice a week on Wednesday evenings and also on Saturday evenings, a 45 minute through Instagram, it's live, where I would pray with people and share a very simple word for them. We're just singing,praying at average about 70,000 people followed us.
Wow.
70,000. And how could you fit 70,000 in a prayer meeting? I don't think our place, even our new place, could fit that.
Yeah.
Right? And then our Sunday services, since going online, about average of 80,000 people.
Wow.
That are following us online. Our church members in Surabaya alone, we are not yet that size. Okay, so and now it's already 80,000 people. Since we are separated physically, the presence gets stronger. And the spiritual gifts also get sharper. I don't know, somehow when I preach as their pastor, giving the message weekly to them, to the congregation, you know, these words of knowledge,they are becoming richer and richer in my ministry, and also the gifts of prophecy, the gift of healing. It's touching people. And just recently, yesterday, last night, I got news: someone in Malaysia with the coronavirus, which he was tested positive, the whole family.
Oh wow!
COVID-19. The whole family, husband, wife, and child got healed almost instantly. After following us online.
Wow.
So God increased his work in our limitations.
Yeah.
At average now 80,000 people follow us online. And the thing is, people who did not want to go to church wholeheartedly now started appreciating church.
Oh yeah.
They are saying that they cannot wait to come join our church.
Wow.
And then the people who are actually have been resistant to going to church, to our church, now the church is being held in their living rooms or in their bedrooms.
Yeah.
And when they stream online our church service, these non-believing members, they will follow as well. Yeah. And they got touched by the Holy Spirit. And I believe when we will resume our worship service physically, I believe that many, many new friends, they will join our church.
Wow, that's incredible. Okay, 我有听说腓力牧师其实已经录了12个礼拜的主日崇拜的信息，
是的，
真的非常非常的厉害。嗯，那我们想要大概想要知道说，你想要在透过这12篇信息3个月，你要分享给弟兄姐妹的最主要的信息是什么？
是，that's this one message that I've given to our church, and I want to give to also to my Taiwanese brothers and sisters, that what seems to be a setback could be just a setup. So please look forward.
Yes.
Do not be contained. I mean, do not be limited by the circumstances now. Whatever happens on the outside, it may not be in our control, but whatever happens on the inside, it is well in our control. So always be strive to find the blessings that are in God. Always be able to spot them. Every season bear fruit. When you are slowed down and you cannot go anywhere, you're limited, so you might as well bear fruit in your relationship with your loved ones.
Yes.
Cherish the time together. This may not get repeated. Time is on your side to be able to redeem all the lost times in the past.
Yes.
And maybe you could acquire more books and read more books, books that you haven't found time to be able to complete. But do not forget the 66 books, the 66 main books in your life,
yes,
which have all been contained in one book called the Bible.
Yes,
this is the time when we could continue keep reading the Bible without being rushed into an appointment we have made with somebody outside because we don't go outside. Look at all this. This is a setback for everybody, but it is actually a setup. When the disciples, the 12 disciples of Jesus, the apostles, they couldn't fish, they couldn't find any, they didn't have any catch. But then during the daytime, the morning, so they went ashore and put the boat and parked their boat, and then they begin to fix their net. As they were fixing their net, Jesus came to them and said, go into the deep, go to the middle of the lake and throw the net on your right. They said, Lord, Master, we've tried doing that the whole entire night. But they said, Lord, because you say so, because you said so, I'm going to go to the deep and throw my net on the right. And then they caught 153 big fish.
Yeah.
But the thing is, this is all due to the Lord's word. But they also owed their success to that time when they did not catch any fish. They went ashore and fixed their net. It was a setback. They didn't have any catch the whole entire night. But that setback was necessary for them to fix something. When the harvest later on would come, they were ready for it and no fish would escape their net.
Yes.
Just imagine if their net somewhat got disconnected somewhere. No matter how big their catch, all the fish will escape through that one tiny hole.
Yeah.
And it would become big hole in no time because these fish are very strong. So remember, this time will never get repeated. Even if it gets repeated, would be something new. So might as well, whatever setback you're experiencing now, be suspicious that this actually a setup for something greater later on.
Yes.
Every day waking up in the morning, ask the Lord to lead you and guide you. Maybe you need to WhatsApp somebody, you need to message somebody. You say you could send a scripture, or you could send some encouraging words to some people. Praying for them over the phone. Some people who have never welcomed you in their home, they probably are waiting for your call to say, hello, how can I pray for you? I don't think people resist prayer nowadays.
Yeah, that's right.
It's the perfect time to preach the gospel to everybody.
Yes.
From your home.
Yes.
And they are trapped in their home. They cannot escape from you. They cannot run away from you.
Yeah, yeah.
Now you call them, they will always answer your phone.
Yeah.
They cannot say, I'm busy. You're lying.
Yeah.
No, I'm not at home. No way. You're at home. So now you have caught your fish. All your fish has been cornered. There's no better place, better time for the church to evangelize their friends. Now it's time.
最后一个问题就是，我们都很想要为腓力牧师、你们的教会还有整个印尼来祷告，所以有没有什么祷告的的一些祷告的需要，我们可以跟我们分享的？
好 ，Pray for us so we will not be selfish.
Yeah.
We pray that we're going to be able to see golden opportunities for us to share the love of Jesus through tangible help, helping people in their physical needs, but also never be blinded by their spiritual needs. This is the perfect time for us to fill those needs.
Amen. 好，那最后我们要请斐利牧师来为我们台湾来祷告。
Okay.
然后祷告完以后，然后我再带领所有的弟兄姐妹一起来为印尼祝福，来为印尼祷告，这样子。那请斐利牧师先为我们祷告。
Okay. Let me pray first.
All right.
亲爱的天父，把我们的生命放在你的手中。我相信，相信主你在你里面凡事都能。
Amen.
耶稣，你有在我们的身上有最好的计划。
Amen.
请耶稣分享在我们一个人的心，从天堂来的那个目标。
Amen.
我们就不能we will not be selfish, we will not be thinking about ourselves, but we're going to be focusing on other people. I pray for Taiwan. That this is the time, ironically, but this is the time when Chinese churches arise to be an answer to their society, to tangible help, and also spiritual help. Thank you, Father. Bless them with peace, supernatural peace. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. 好，那所有的弟兄姐妹，我们也一起来为斐利牧师还有为整个印尼来祝福来祷告。亲爱的主耶稣，我们把印尼交在你的手中，把斐利牧师还有他们的教会还有在印尼所有的基督徒都交在你的手中。主，我们求你赐下你的平安，主，赐下你的医治，主，在这个国家的里面，主，真的让我们看见，主，虽然有这样子的疫情，但是主，你却让家庭的关系更多的被恢复，好像教会的合一也更多的被恢复。哦，主要在这个国家的当中，主要我们也求你，因为你是使万事都互相效力的神。哦，主要你就来祝福印尼，你来祝福他们的教会。哦，主要真的是能够看见在这样的一个光景的当中，哦，主要你反而让福音更多的兴旺起来。哦，主要让弟兄姐妹更多的跨越出去，成为那个福音的传福音的管道，主要成为那个恩典跟祝福的管道，去满足人的需要，去为人不管是物质上面的需要，属灵上面的需要，哦，主啊，都求你赐给他们智慧，也赐给他们各样属天的资源，还有赐给他们从那里来的爱，能够去 reach out， 能够去接触到这些更多的人，为着你福音的缘故，主啊，为着你国度的缘故。耶稣，谢谢你，赞美你，祝福印尼在这样的疫情的当中仍然要看见你荣耀的工作。这样祷告奉靠主耶稣的名求， Amen，
Amen。
谢谢，谢谢斐利牧师，我们很高兴可以跟你有这样子的连线，感谢主，再见，
拜拜，再见。